Hi, in this segment, I will introduce you to the Deal.II website, and then we'll look at a way of running your code on your own machine using a virtual machine through Oracle Virtualbox. All right, so let's go to the screen now. We'll actually go first to the Coursera website, and if you scroll down, on the left, there's a Resources tab with links to different websites and other resources. So at the very top is the Deal.II website. It's actually just at deal2.org with the two as a double I. There are three things I wanted to show you about the Deal.II website. The first, under 8.2.1, which is the current Deal.II release, we'll go to tutorials. The tutorials are really just example programs. And if we scroll down, you see a graph or a schematic of how the different tutorials relate to each other. They sort of build off each other and become more sophisticated the higher the numbers go. We'll go to number 8, which is elasticity, which is something that you'll be coding yourself at some point, although it will be a little bit different format. Now, I really like the way these tutorials are set up. The first part of the tutorial, as you can see, goes through the underlying physics and the equations, the governing equations involved. You can see it gives a pretty in-depth explanation of what's going on and what you will be modeling, or what they are modeling in this tutorial. It also gives relations to other tutorials and where you might want to take it further. The next section is what's called the commented program, and as you can see, it has comments, paragraphs of explanation interspersed with the code itself. All right, it explains the header files, the templates that are going on, the different function names, and so on, as well as the Deal.II data types. Okay, so that section is quite long, so I'll scroll down. It also goes over the results. But then at the very end is the plain program. So if you just want to see the code itself, here it is at the very bottom, so you can look through it and see what's going on. There are several of these programs, or these example programs, these tutorials, and so they're really helpful, especially if you want to move on beyond this course and use Deal.II in your own research or for your own work. This is really helpful for learning Deal.II on both a simple and an advanced level. All right, go back to the Deal.II website really quickly here. The other thing I wanted to show you, or one of the other things, is the download page. We actually won't be expecting you to, or you won't need to download Deal.II and install it on your own machine, but if you do want to, this is how you do it. You can install it on Linux, and that would be this first archive file, this tar.gz file. You would download it to your Linux computer, and here are the instructions for installing that. It's actually really simple to install it on a Mac. Here are the binary packages and the instructions there. Another option that Deal.II has on their website is a virtual machine image, and I'll go into that a little bit more. We actually won't be using Deal.II's virtual machine image because it doesn't have the HDF5 library installed, which is necessary for creating the homework submission file. So actually, if you're going to be installing this on your own computer, whether it's a Linux or a Mac machine, you'll need to make sure the HDF5 library is installed. If you want to run it on Windows, there may be ways to do it by creating a Linux environment, such as using Cygwin. But it's probably going to be easier to use the virtual machine that I'll be talking about in this segment, or AWS, which I'll be talking about in a future segment. All right. The third part of the Deal.II website that is extremely helpful is their documentation on the Deal.II classes and functions, such as the Deal.II vector, the Deal.II full matrix, and so on. And I actually usually don't access that through the Deal.II website itself initially. I access it by going to a search engine like Google and searching Deal.II vector, for example. And it's usually at the very top of the results. Okay, so here's vector class template reference. And the top of the page shows how this vector class relates to other classes. That can be pretty extensive with things like a full matrix. With a vector, it's a little more simple. And then it goes through the public and private member types and data types associated with a vector. So it goes through the different constructors, functions like reinit, explains the different operators involved. All right, so there are quite a lot of functions here. And if you want to know how to use one more in depth or a more in-depth explanation, just click on the link. It scrolls down to the right spot on the web page. Okay. And Deal.II's documentation is really good. That's one of the reasons we chose to use Deal.II with this course. Okay. So those are the three main things about the Deal.II website that I wanted to show you. Of course, there's more to the website than that, and feel free to explore. All right, but now I want to shift over and look at the virtual machine. Okay, so to do that, we'll go back to the Coursera website under resources again. We'll be using this virtual machine through Oracle's VirtualBox. So here's the link to download that. It's an application that you can use on Linux or Windows or Mac. Okay, so whatever type of operating system you're using, you should be able to use VirtualBox. Okay, it's a pretty it's pretty straightforward to download and install. It's not a huge file. It doesn't take up a lot of space on your computer by itself. Okay, but once you've installed VirtualBox, you'll want to go back to Coursera, and you'll download the virtual machine appliance. Now, this is what has all the software that you'll be using. Okay, and it's a Linux appliance. It's a Ubuntu virtual machine. Okay, it's a .ova file. So you would just click on this. It would download it. As you can see, it's 2 gigabytes, so it's a pretty big file. I'm not going to download it again to my computer. It can take quite a while depending on your internet connection, okay? But once you've downloaded your .ova file, then you would go to VirtualBox, which you already have installed, and you'll open that up. I've already imported the appliance to my machine, but I'll show you how you would do that on yours. Go up to File, Import Appliance, and then you would browse to where that file was downloaded. So here it's in my Downloads folder. Press Open. And next would take me to the different settings. Okay, you shouldn't have to change any of these settings, probably. And then you would press Import. Now, it would take about 20 or 30 minutes to import, so I won't press Import again here. I'll just press Cancel, but again, of course, you would press Import. Okay, now once it's imported, your screen will look like this. Okay, so you press Start, and it can take a little while to bring up the screen. Okay, and the first time it's running here for you, it may come up with this error, like it does for me. It says implementation of the USB 2.0 controller not found. I just press OK, and I'll go to Settings, making sure, of course, that virtual machine is selected still. Go down to USB, and I'll deselect Enable USB 2.0 controller. Press OK, and now I'll go back to Start. So again, this is an Ubuntu virtual machine image. And so as it comes up, you may not need to use it, but the username and password will be Ubuntu. So if you ever need to use it as a super user using sudo. It does take a little bit for the screen to come up. Okay, so we're loading Xubuntu now. And even though it's a small screen now, we can make it full screen so that it's as if you're actually working on an Ubuntu machine. It is a virtual desktop here, and everything is actually located right on your own laptop, so you don't need an internet connection once everything's installed. And again, this works with Linux, Mac, or Windows. Now, after it's installed, it does the virtual machine appliance does expand to hold to take up a fair amount of space on your hard drive, something like 7 gigabytes, 7 or 8 gigabytes. Okay, so you will need about that much space on your hard drive in order to use this option. Okay, so you can see it is its own desktop. I'll switch to full screen mode. It has its own web browser here, so Chromium. You go up to the top left is where you'll access the different applications. So actually, the web browser here doesn't work. You go over here to the right to Internet, and then you can go into Chromium. You can go to Development, and you have Emacs for a text editor for editing your code. Let's see, accessories. LeafPad is also a text editor, but it's not necessarily meant for editing code. It is there, though. It's quite a bit simpler than Emacs. Another thing is you have an archive manager because your code template will be downloaded as a .zip file. So you can use Archive Manager to unzip your files. And then remember, when you're submitting your homework files, you will be creating a zip file of all the submission files. So again, you can use Archive Manager to do that. So everything you need to do for your homework, you can do right here within this virtual machine because you have the text editor, you have the web page, or the web browser, you have the Archive Manager, you also have Visit to visualize your code. Okay, you can double-click that and it opens up the GUI. Okay, of course, now the main thing that you need to know how to do on here is how to run your code, right? So up here as well, you would go to Terminal Emulator. And here you have your terminal to actually run your code. Okay, so do ls. So we'd want to, for an example, I'll go into the Deal.II examples. So it's cd Deal.II examples. And here it has step one and so on. These correspond to the tutorials that we saw on the Deal.II website. So if I go into step eight, you can see it has a cmakelist.txt file and the step eight.cc. So the first step to run your code is to do cmake and then cmakelist.txt and press enter. So this will create a make file that's specific to our .cc file, to our source code. Okay, so now if I press ls, you can see it's created several different files, including this make file. And the make file will compile and run our code. So I can do make run. And it will run step eight for us. It does take a little bit of time just to compile your code, even if it doesn't take a long time to run it on the virtual machine. It does take a little while to compile it and link everything. And here it's finally linking and running it for us. Okay, so now if we list the files, you can see it created several VTK files which you could open up and visit and look at. All right, and so you'll be, when you run your code, you'll be doing something similar. You'll have a cmakelist.txt file as well as some source code. Of course, you'll be editing the source code and you'll be running it using cmake. Okay, so that should be enough to get you going with the virtual machine. And in the future segments, we'll be talking about how to run your code using AWS.